Hello, my dear students. Welcome to my channel, Maths with Panitra. In this session, we are going to discuss about the integration by parts in JNNs and MCET. How to apply these type of concept? First, we will discuss about the integration by parts, when we have to apply, and we will discuss about the formula of integration by parts, regular method as well as shortcut formula. See, in the differentiation, the product of two functions to differentiate, we have UV rule, d by dx of u into v. That means u into v dash plus v into u dash. Similarly, to integrate the product of two functions, we have an integration by parts formula in integration. See how we are going to apply the formula. Integral f of x into g of x into dx. To integrate the product of two functions, therefore integral f of x g of x dx equal to f of x into integral g of x dx minus integral f dash of x derivative of f of x into integral g of x dx whole dx. This formula is called integration by parts. While evaluating the product of two functions in integration, we have to follow the integration by parts formula. While applying this formula, the product of two functions are there. Integral x into e power x, integral x into sin x, integral x log x. Like this, possibilities will come. Here one doubt will arise. Among these two functions, f of x and g of x, which function you have to consider a f of x, which function you have to consider a g of x? To avoid that confusion, we have the formula I laid. Here, in this, we will explain the I laid rule, I am going to highlight this in this class. So, what represents I? I indicates inverse trigonometry functions. So, like sine inverse x, sine h inverse x, cot inverse x, like this. What L represents? L indicates logarithmic functions. That is log x, log of ax plus b, and so on. Next, a indicates algebraic functions. Algebraic functions. It's like x plus 2, ax plus b, or ax squared plus bx plus c. Like this, expansions or expressions will be there. Algebraic functions. And come to T. T indicates trigonometric functions. That is like sine x, cos x, sine hx, hyperbolic trigonometry also includes. And here E represents exponential functions like e power ax plus b, a power x, a power cx plus d. Like this, expansions it will go there. See, to represent among these two functions, which function you have to consider f of x, which function you have to consider g of x. Suppose, for example, the question integral x into e power x into dx is there. Here, x indicates algebraic, e power x indicates exponential. Among these two, which one is coming first in the order? I, L, A, T, E. In this, A is coming first one, E is coming as third, second one next. So, this you can consider as f of x. This you can consider as g of x. After that, you can apply integration by parts. See here, f of x into x into integral g of x, integral e power x minus integral f dash of x, x derivative is 1 into integral e power x dx whole dx, which is equal to x e power x minus integral, integral e power x is e power x into dx, which is equal to x e power x minus integral e power x is e power x plus c. So x e power x take common, e power x into x minus 1 plus c. Now onwards, you remember the shortcut formula also. Integral x e power x dx is equal to e power x into x minus 1 plus c. This is the use of integration by parts. Whenever product of two functions are there, among these two functions, which one you have to consider as f of x, which one you have to consider as g of x, by taking the help of IA rule. See, one more example. X sin x, integral x sin x into dx. Here x indicates algebraic, this is algebraic function. Sin x indicates trigonometry. Among algebraic and trigonometric, algebraic is coming first function in the order. So this is the first function f of x, this is the second function g of x. According to the rule of integration by parts, you learn that you get the values of f dash of x and integral g of x. So now by using integration by parts, f of x into, that means x into, integral g of x, that means integral sin x dx minus integral f dash of x, x derivative is 1, into integral sin x dx whole dx, so which is equal to x into integral sin x is minus cos x minus integral 1 into integral sin x is minus cos x into dx. So minus into minus is plus, minus x cos x plus integral cos x is sin x plus c, so which is equal to sin x minus x cos x plus c. After expanding of after by regular method, integral x sin x and here integral x e power x. Here I am going to introduce that the shortcut formula also. The shortcut formula. Among these two functions, we need to get this answer now here accordingly. Integral x sin x dx is equal to this answer, we got it. By using shortcut formula here, shortcut method I am highlighting here. First I will rub this, after that I will explain. It is easy to understand. Yeah, we will discuss here by using the regular method, by using integration by parts, we got this answer. Similar question, same question, we will do by shortcut formula. Integral x into e power x into dx. I will write directly this answer, see how it is. This is algebraic, this is exponential function, it is coming as a, according to the Euler formula order, it is f of x, this is g of x. F of x function, you have to differentiate till constant comes, x derivative is, so function x here, e power x. First one differentiate, second function you have to integrate. X d by dx of x is 1. D by dx of, sorry, integral of e power x is e power x. Again, d by dx of 1 is 0. Integral of e power x is e power x. You can stop it here. After differentiating of the first function till get the constant terms, constant, and the second function you have to integrate. These two, product of these two plus product of these two minus. After that there is no term, you can leave it. Whenever you are getting 0 here, you can leave. So x into e power x minus 1 into e power x minus e power x. After that constant you can keep after integration. Take common e power x into x minus 1 plus e. You got it the same value, no? This is by using shortcut formula. So how to, what is the procedure to do the shortcut formula? Among the two functions, first you have to recognize what is f of x, what is g of x. For f of x, you have to differentiate till 0 comes, and g of x, you have to differentiate, you have to integrate till this place. Simultaneously, you do that. That function, first function differentiation till 0 comes, and g of x, you have to integrate. After that, you can product, you can do the like this way. Similarly, I will explain integral x sin x dx by using shortcut formula. Listen, this is the method 2. This is method 1. This is method 1. Method 2 I am doing. Method 2. Shortcut formula. Integral x into sin x dx. From this, x is belongs to algebraic, sin x is trigonometry. So algebraic is coming first, trigonometry is coming next. After recognizing f of x and g of x, we already discussed the f of x function, you have to differentiate till constant comes. That means constant also, till 0 comes. X derivative, d by dx of x, from here x derivative is 1, sin x here, sin x integration is minus cos x, constant 1 derivative is 0, cos x integration is sin x, already minus is there, minus sin x. So now what we have to do that, here plus, here minus, so now, which is equal to x into minus cos x minus x cos x minus into minus. See, already minus is there. 1 into minus sin x is minus sin x. So minus of minus sin x plus sin x after integration plus c. So first sin x minus x cos x plus c. That's what we got the same answer now. Sin x minus x cos x, sin x minus x cos x plus c. So this is by using shortcut formula, shortcut method. Yeah, we will discuss the different problems based on that. Yeah, in this integration by parts, one important thing, other than identifying f of x and g of x, suppose while evaluating integral log x dx, integral tan inverse x into dx, like these functions are there, integral sin inverse x, integral of any inverse trigonometry function or hyperbolic inverse trigonometry functions or any single log x function, logarithmic function. How to integrate this type of problems? So whenever like this integration or logarithmic functions are there, single functions are there, integral log x can be written as integral log x into 1 into dx. That log x given function, you have to assume that f of x, 1 you can take as g of x. So to apply integration by parts for this type of problems, you have to consider 1 as g of x. So here, integral tan inverse x into 1 into dx, in this f of x and g of x. So in what way you are taking as f of x is the given function and considering 1 is g of x is the second function. See, log x in Eilert formula, in Eilert formula, f of x is belongs to logarithmic, no? This is f of x. 1 is belongs to algebraic, that is g of x. Among these two, which is coming first? L is coming first. That means f of x we are considering as a first function. Come to here. This is inverse trigonometry function. It is there in Eilert formula. In Eilert formula, f of x is inverse trigonometry function. That is the reason f of x I am considering. 1 it belongs to g of x. It is algebraic, second function. So after that you can apply integration by parts easily. And integral log x dx directly also, you remember as a shortcut formula what we are getting the answer. F of x into, that means log x into, integral 1 into dx minus integral f dash of x, log x derivative is 1 by x, into integral g of x, integral 1 into dx, whole dx. So which is equal to log x, integral 1 into dx is x, minus integral 1 by x into integral 1 into dx is x into dx. So x, x get cancelled. So x log x minus integral dx. Integral dx is x. X into log x minus integral dx is x plus c. Now take x common from these two. Integral x log x into dx. Sorry, integral log x, only log x, sorry. Therefore, integral log x dx is equal to x into log x minus 1 plus c. You remember as a shortcut formula, this one, which is very, very important. Keep in mind and practice. Come to this one. This is also an example. Integration by parts again. F of x into tan inverse x into integral g of x, integral 1 into dx minus integral f dash of x, tan inverse x derivative is 1 by 1 plus x square, into integral 1 into dx whole dx, which is equal to tan inverse x, integral 1 into dx, integral dx is x, minus integral 1 by 1 plus x square into integral dx is x into dx. After that, x into tan inverse x minus integral x by 1 plus x square into dx. 1 plus x square derivative is 2x. So 2x is not there in the numerator. So multiplying by 2, dividing by 2, which is equal to x into tan inverse x minus 1 by 2 into log mod 1 plus x square, which is in this form of integral f dash of x by f of x into dx, which is equal to log mod f of x formula. So it will becomes, so therefore integral tan inverse x into dx is equal to x into tan inverse x minus half into log mod 1 plus x squared plus c. Thank you dear students for watching my channel. Please do subscribe and share to your friends and relatives. If you have any doubts in this regard, you can write to my comment box in my channel. I will respond whenever I will free. Thank you all.